Hi, I'm here to show you how to get Sofia Vergara inspired hair. The first thing we're gonna do is set Kristen's hair with a really light working spray so that we can get some curls to hold inside of her hair. So kind of getting it evenly distributed throughout, and don't be afraid to take a brush and run it through so that you're not curling in tangles into your hair, because you want it to be movable and really soft. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna actually use two different size brushes, and we're gonna take sections of hair and not have it in between the tongue and the barrel. So just holding it like this. And because it is a more curled look, you wanna make sure that you're leaving the iron in the hair for longer periods of time. So around the face, I recommend using a fatter curling iron, and then right after you move out of the fringe area, dropping back into a smaller iron. So I'm just doing this too around her face because it's easier for me and I'm here, so I may as well be a little bit useful. So I'm gonna go ahead and trade you irons and just go through and curl it in both directions. And I'll trade you irons back when I want you to use a bigger iron. And if you have some sort of mitten or glove, putting it on the hand that isn't holding the iron will keep you from burning yourself. I know it's really easy to do that, so you have to be pretty careful. So don't worry about getting the ends of your hair curled in the iron. If it's a little bit too unfinished at the ends, you can go through and put it in between the tongue and the barrel to finish those ends. You're doing a great job. And as you could see, as I was curling her hair, I was holding the barrel vertically and she's holding it a little bit more horizontally. It's whatever is most comfortable for you, as long as you move the hair in opposite directions. And after that section, I'm gonna actually trade you irons again. And the reason why we're doing two different irons is so it's not too terribly uniform, but it's also, the size of the irons aren't like crazy different, so if you only have one curling iron, this will be a look that will work for you. And right in the front of your hair, wrapping it away from your face is a really soft look, and it's a look that is complementary to most face shapes, hair types, and initial looks as well. Okay, and after that one, we're gonna trade irons again. And if the section slides out of your hand, don't be afraid to just pick it back up and wrap it back up. Sometimes it takes a few attempts. Sometimes it takes a few attempts when I'm the one doing your hair. So don't let that get in your way or discourage you. So there are just a couple sections in the back that I'm gonna do. She can do them herself, but it would require a back mirror, and we don't have that for her right now, so that's why I'm doing it for her. But it's easy to do the back of your hair. You just pull it around your shoulder and wrap it. And a really important key to what Kristen was doing when she was wrapping her own hair is she wasn't keeping her elbows very high. She was keeping them on the lower side, which is a lot less stress on your shoulders and ultimately is more comfortable for you, and you'll be more able to complete the look without getting tired. And as you're curling your hair, if some pieces aren't as curly as others, that's okay. You don't want everything to be the exact same curliness, because that's what ends up giving you more of a Shirley Temple look as opposed to the soft, sort of sexy, kind of tousled result that we're looking for right now. And when you're curling this, when you're done, this is the last section I'm going to do. When you're done curling, don't be afraid to really run your fingers through it and get it to look the way that you want it to look. So you're running your fingers through it. You want to soften the curliness of places. And if you see places where it's not as curly as you would like them to be, don't be afraid to take your iron back in there. Right around the face, I'm actually going to go in and put the hair in between the iron so that I have a little bit more control with it. Because she had a little bit of a bump in her hair before, and we want to smooth that bump out. And I'm loving the way that she did it around her face. She did a really great job. So just going and taking your fingers through and placing your hair where you like it. I also like to take a little bit of a fiber to piece the look out a little bit so that you don't have kind of a mass of hair. You take certain pieces and you define curls, which is kind of how Sofia had her hair looking. It wasn't all just sort of the same texture and the same going in the same direction. She had some pieces that were more defined than others. So that's what we're doing right here. And softening it around the face is really key. You want to have that softness. So that is how you get Sofia Vergara inspired hair.